Welcome to the Joy of Art Studio. Today I'm going to do something a little bit different. I've been working on doing the landscapes and the seascapes for the past few weeks, so I kind of wanted to get a bit creative today. And I've got an exhibition coming up at a rock concert at the end of September, and they want some kind of wild thing. So it's all kind of flower power and all that kind of stuff. So I'm going to show you something that I'm going to do, which you could easily do yourself. It's really easy and really good fun, so I hope you enjoy it. Okay, so I'm just going to talk you through what we're going to do and how we're going to do it. First of all, I've got some gloves because it's going to be quite messy. And the most important thing is to be prepared. So I've got this reasonable sized canvas, and I've already gessoed it, so I've given it like a primer as a good base. And I've got all my paints mixed out ready, so I decided on all my colours. And what I've done with these is I've mixed some paint with a little bit of medium and some water till they're kind of a runny consistency. But just in case they get too dry, I've got my little spray bottle just to, because it's so hot here, you know, they dry really quickly, and some little lollipop sticks I've got to stir. You're going to see what I'm going to do. So I've got my colours already prepared, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to cover the whole of the canvas in white paint, and I've mixed some white paint with a little bit of glaze to give it a nice texture on on the background of the picture. We're actually going to do some really nice flowers. So I've got this paint here, and I've got my sticks, and I've got kitchen roll, and I've got my notes. So off we go. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to pour some of this out on the canvas. Maybe that's enough for a minute. Let's see how far it is go. And I'm going to just spread it out on the canvas. It's actually really dry, so I'm just watering it a little to give it a little bit more. I want it to kind of stay wet for what we're going to do, and I don't want it to dry too quickly, so I'm just giving it a bit more water. This is the problem. We love living in Spain, but when it's hot, it's hot. And it's not good when you want to do acrylic painting that you don't want to dry too quickly. I'm actually going to put a bit more of this on just to make sure. I actually made quite a lot of it, so hopefully it should be all right. I'm going to just have to work quickly, which is good for you, and then you won't get bored. So just wiping this over. And it's really great to do it with your fingers. The best brushes that we have are fingers. Right, now I'm going to just give that another spray just to keep it really moist while I'm showing you the rest. Okay, that's great. Don't want it to be even, it's just got to look kind of natural, organic, so easy to do, no brushes, just fingers. Okay, so I'm going to just wipe the excess off my hand, off my gloves. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to do some flowers. So now I've actually prepared all that, I'm going to turn it up, bring it down so you can see, and I'm going to pour this some flowers. So you're going to see what I'm going to do. So to begin with, I've got relatively dark red, nice red, kind of crimsony dark red, and I'm just going to make a little puddle. It's called puddle painting, this. So I've got a nice puddle of that, and I've got a beautiful pink, if you can see here, it's a wonderful pink. That's going to go just in the middle. Okay. And then I've got yellow, so yellow is going to go in the middle of that. It's exciting, isn't it, to see what's going to happen. So a little bit of yellow, put a bit more water in that. It's quite thick. Mix it up a bit. And some dark red again in the middle of the yellow. Okay. Then the pink again. Okay, and then I'm just going to drop a little bit of white into the middle of that. It's quite thick. I'm going to put some more water in here. See how quickly it dries. Okay, so that's our first one. Our second one now I'm going to do over here, and that's going to be blue. So I've got some dark blue mixed here. I think it's runny enough. Might just put a bit more water in. So I'm going to drop the blue over here. Okay, it's puddling out, which is great. Then I've got some light blue. And this is actually a bit polarized, so it's kind of interesting what this is going to do. So I'm going to put some of the light blue in the middle. I've got some beautiful purple, so that's going to go on top of the light blue. Like that. And where are we? Purple, I'm going to do light blue again. Don't matter about the splosh, because we're going to see what's going to do with that in a minute. Okay. A bit of dark blue again on top of this. Okay. And then I'm just going to put a little bit of white on the top of that. Not too much, I don't want it too white. Okay, so that's our second flower. And then our third flower is going to go down here. So I'm going to start with the light blue first on this one. So that's going to go here. Okay, maybe a bit more. And then we're going to go with the purple. It's kind of pinky purple. Okay. Then I've got a darker purple here, which is really lovely. It's again, it's kind of quite pearly. A bit more water in here. These sprays are great, you know. They're a lifesaver because they keep everything moist without kind of saturating everything. So that's a different colour purple on the top, you can see. Okay. And then I'm going to put light blue on top of that. Okay, we're going to so you'll see what we're going to do. And then we'll finish lovely pinky purple on the top there. Okay. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to turn this round this way, and I'm going to blow it into petal shapes. Well, that's what I hope anyway. So let's see what's going to happen. See what's happening? Oh, it's so nice. Great, look at that. Wonderful how those colours mix. so I think I could afford to do a bit more here. There we go. Okay, yeah. Love it. And I want to just, I think, drop a little bit of white in the middle. Let's just see. Just a bit. Just a bit more. And I'm just going to see what happens if I do this. Yeah. That's great. Okay, so that's number one. Now let's come to this one. Same thing. Doesn't matter if they splodge into each other, it's fine. Look at that. Fantastic. Now, well, I don't know what quite's going on here, but actually I'm going to dab that out a bit. I can cover it in some white, let it dry. Obviously caught it on something, but never mind. I'm going to go one more time here. That's it, maybe one more time here. See what's happening, it looks brilliant. Okay. And again. You see, it looks great, eh? Okay, so finally what we're going to do now, having blown them all out into the shapes, you can see it's turned out really nicely. I'm going to turn it back this way, and then I'm just going to add some stems just to make it look interesting. Again, I'm going to use my stick because it's kind of a nice thing to just be natural. And I think I'm going to come sort of down here. And it's going to pass down here and put a few little petals on the underneath here. So you're just keeping it really, really interesting and nice. A little leaf maybe here. Okay, maybe a leaf here. Just want to kind of keep it really natural. And we're going to do the same from here. Let's bring this down through here. Make a nice leaf here. See, the white paint's still wet, so it's kind of nice to see, kind of runs into it, so it's easy to do. See what's happening? And then we'll just do one here. Bring this one here. And put a little leaf on it here. Yeah, I think that's kind of looking good. And I'll turn it around so you can see it in a second. And then I think the last thing I'm going to do is just define the edges a bit, but I'm kind of questioning that. I sort of rather like it as it is. So I'll just turn it round. I don't want to turn it up because it will run. But just so you can see the effect of how that is. Isn't it lovely? It's just a very natural, organic, pretty little picture, which you can do with all the huffing and puffing and blowing, but makes me laugh really. You can create such a nice painting which has got some energy in it and colour and dynamism, and you know, you can do different designs with it. So there we go, and I hope you've enjoyed that little experiment, and I look forward to seeing you on the next video. Okay, you take care, bye for now.